On prime time? What is that?
They're making a mockery out of my words, man. This whole thing is turning into a theatrical mockery. You understand that, Mike?
No.
Well, you will. I'm gonna go in there flying, man, and read this fucker like it's supposed to be read, because I've had it.
You stupid fucking bitch! This is 186 fucking minute phone call at goddamn prime time!
I paid the fucking bill!
I'm calling you to let you know that there is a cast meeting tomorrow night.
Looks like there's a lot of work we have to kind of like scrape together, and hopefully everything will collide and we'll make our deadline.
See, I come to the airport all the time when I want to work. There's no phones ringing, there's no people talking to you, and if you're hungry, it's like tough shit. You know, you can't stop and justify your inaction of script writing by making a pizza or something. Man, you got to be in this car. You have no other choice. Why the hell are we here? We're working on Northwestern, the third draft. I've got to get it so it's not embarrassing to give out, you know what I mean? There's some corny dialogue that would make the Pope weep, and I've got to resurrect that, so to speak. I feel so trapped. You know how long we've been living together? Since high school. She dropped out, I graduated. Her dad sold the house, it's almost paid off. Why don't you move out? It's a free country. I don't know. I guess it's just one of those things. Who the hell in their right mind would tell the world, yeah, I'm gonna do this, and then think, man, where am I gonna, I'm broke, man, I gotta get gas tomorrow, and dude's talking about making a feature film, shit.
Now we're gonna talk about high-level negotiations, because for the first time in your life, you're gonna make a profit, man, just like that.
No, you haven't even started at all, hardly. Well, not hard, you did start somewhat, yeah, but not very much.
Bill traditionally is quite close to his money, and it's quite a challenge to pry anything loose from him money-wise. And Mark, on the other hand, has, if anybody, the ability to pry it loose.
I'll show you something, William. Talk to me.
Wow.
That's
right.
How
about that? Wow.
She wants to be in your film, Bill.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, we can start then. Tom, why don't you show us what you got, as in the way of breakdown?
My duties on Northwestern are those of the production manager.
Yeah, I've gone over the script on a scene-by-scene basis, and we've got it all broken down, color-coded, broken down. So everything from, you know, from cast to props to atmosphere stunts.
I think what Mark's idea of a film, of this film, and Tom Beach's idea of a film are just so different. Both of them are knowledgeable filmmakers, but it's a different kind of knowledge. One's more primeval and one's more textbook.
The location type, which would be interior day, night, exterior night, day.
So you got to get a cameraman, you got to get a sound recorder, a boom operator, an assistant cameraman to do the clap like that. And then you want a couple others on the sideline running things
as
around.
As far as where Mark's film stands now, I'm not really too sure. I know that we sort of have had a breakdown in communication lately.
Thanks a lot, though.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you know what'd be really cool is a cup of coffee.
Okay, I'll make
it. So I can get the hell out of this bed. And you know how many phone calls there are sitting there?
Oh yeah. Yeah.
A lot.
I'll put on the coffee.
I'd like to sleep here all day, but I can't, man. I gotta get type up sheets and have them copied for the meeting tonight. Man, I gotta get some information across.
But man, there's no excuses, Paul. No one has ever paid admission to see an excuse. No one has ever faced a black screen that says, well, if we had these set of circumstances, we would have shot this scene, so please forgive us and use your imagination. I've been to the movies hundreds of times. That's never occurred. You know, it's like you're the lone man on this, lone captain on this big-ass ocean liner, man. And it's like, goddamn, I need people to cook the food. I need people to run the motors. I need people to make sure that we don't go into the rocks and so forth like that. And oh, my God.
And at about 12:30, the realization seriously hit me. No way. I have absolutely no fucking money. I have no hope of getting any money until Colvin is finished. Aesthetically, I'm not ready. The script is not ready. The casting hasn't even begun. The locations are scant at best. Are you crazy? That's 11 days away from now.
My first impression of him was, you know, he looks like a pretty raw dog. You know, he's pretty tall and crazy looking. I liked it.
He showed a lot of promise as far as schooling, that is, his testing was concerned. Not that he was that great a student, but he qualified for that gifted schooling system they have in Milwaukee.
He dropped out of high school because he thought he didn't learn anything there.
His main asset is really just his mouth, his talking, and he can be pretty convincing, you know, because he's very assertive, very aggressive. And but what he actually can do, I think that he's just best suited for working in a factory, maybe.
When he decided to join the Army, I think that was not only a decision to get away from here, but to try to straighten out his life. And that didn't work too well.
And Mark moved back from the Army and said, you know, let's make another film, you know, and made a couple other shorts, you know, from there. And then along came Colvin.
This is ridiculous. We started May 94, man. We've got every F-stop known to man in the film. And right now, we gotta take action, man. We gotta go out to that field, put those scarecrows in on a killer slant. You know, they've been there for years. The farm's burnt down. It's gonna be the opening shots for Colvin, you know?
And what is Colvin?
Colvin's a 35-minute direct market thriller film shot on 16mm black and white reversal. It's an alcoholic, man, compelled to go to this group meeting by his one and only friends left, but they're not that helpful to group, you know? You know about the group thing?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's what we're doing a film on. Colvin, man, we gotta get this sucker done, though, seriously. Last night, man, I was so drunk, I was calling Morocco, man, calling, trying to get to the Hotel Hilton at Tangiers in Casablanca, man. That's pathetic, man. Is that what you wanna do with your life? Suck down peppermint schnapps and try to call Morocco at 2 a.m? That's senseless, but that's what happens, man. So anyway, we're out here today to try to redeem it, get these establishing shots for Colvin, and, you know, do what you can. You know, we're in America today, and we're ready to roll.
One, two, three.
But check it out, Mike. Now, do you know about the placement of the scarecrows? What they're doing here? Like, one's got to be, like, on this angle, and then the other one's going to be on the other angle. And check it out when you look at the scarecrows. Do you see? Do you get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
We did a lot of fun things making the movie. We one time we brought Mark's car into a vacant drive-through theater, took iron rods and smashed up his car. And another time we dragged Mark like head first through a swamp like 25 times.
Colvin relates to Northwesters in this sense. If I don't go into the black with Colvin, if I don't make money back off of Colvin, how the hell am I going to make Northwestern? I've got to make money back on Colvin. So when I did these figures, 500, 1,000, 2,000, and 3,000 units, right? I said, check this out. Fuck this, man. I'm sorry for erasing that, but it's 3,000 units for 45 grand. Because if I don't get that 45 grand, man, I will not be shit. So there's no 500 copies, there's no 1,000, there's no 2,000. There's fucking 3,000 to be sold. Because if I don't get that, I will never get the ability to make Northwestern. You're signing for it because those checks are going to be in Northwest Productions' name and 3,000 plus interest if you want it.
Northwestern's name.
That's the title of the company. That's who the checks get made out to. $3,000 of those checks goes to you. You get your $3,000 back.
Doesn't sound very kosher to me.
Okay,
just make sure they're endorsed Northwest Productions.
Northwest Productions,
right.
Okay.
And put into that.
And he's the only